Today we are talking about coach calls. Something that, you know, I think folks think a lot about, but don't actually put a lot of thought into how they're going about it. They don't know how to prepare or how to practice. And so that's what I'm going to talk about today. And like I mentioned, I'm going to spend a couple minutes talking about preparation first. How can you best prepare yourself so that you can say what you want to say, you can learn what you want to learn, and you can leave a good impression on the coach through the process? How can you prepare? We're then going to talk about some techniques for actually practicing, which I think a lot of folks skip over. And then again, we'll address the pressure that can go along with having these calls. And so in terms of preparation, I am a big fan of actually physically preparing, not just spending some time thinking about it, but physically creating some things to help you on the call, almost like a study sheet or cheat sheet that your teacher might let you have for a test. Put down some notes, put down some formulas, you know, something just like that, that you can have to reference for yourself on the call. If you get stuck, if a coach hits you with a curveball question and, you know, you kind of panic a little bit, you know, having some actual physically prepared materials will help you adjust to that. And so here's what I recommend. These aren't hard and fast rules. These are just sort of general ideas that I've come up with over, you know, the 7 years I've been working at CaptainU, my time as a college athlete and as a high school recruit. So, you know, these are just guidelines, certainly not hard and fast rules. But here's what I think you should prepare before a coach call. First of all, 5 to 7 key points about you that you think are important things for a coach to know about you, things that are going to convince this coach that they need you on their team. Now, when we talk about your profile and we talk about messaging, I usually say 3 to 5 bullet points and keep those focused on your sport. This 5 to 7 key points, I think 3 to 5 of them should be related to the sport, and then a handful of them can be related to other things as well, your academics, other things that you do outside of your sport. You know, coaches don't, like I've said many, many times, they don't recruit a stat, they don't recruit a video, they don't recruit a message, they recruit people. And so you are going to want to be confident and comfortable speaking about yourself. And I know for some of us, that's a lot easier if we know what we want to say and if we can kind of practice the way that we want to say things and we can think about what supporting evidence we can use to give examples and anecdotes and things like that. So have 5 to 7 key things about you prepared. You know, maybe, you know, hey, I am a strong academic student athlete who, you know, really started taking the sport seriously at this age, and I've gotten these accolades, and these are my key strengths as an athlete. These are my key strengths as a student. And maybe here's one thing I'm really passionate about outside of my sport. You know, having those things prepared, 5 to 7 key points about you that demonstrate that you are a motivated, competent, you know, somebody who a coach is going to want to have on their team. Beyond those 5 to 7 key points, make sure you've got 2 to 3 kind of bits of supporting evidence for each of those. If you say, hey, I'm the fastest person on the field, make sure to have some evidence to back that up. Maybe you've got like your 100 time, or maybe you've got a video of you just totally outpacing somebody on the field. You know, have something to demonstrate what it is that you're saying, so that if a coach says, hey, cool, can you send that over? Boom, you've got it right away. You can follow up right after the call. You're not having to wait a week between when the coach has an opportunity to speak with other athletes. You know, recruiting sometimes is about striking when the iron's hot. And so having everything prepared in advance will really kind of give you the firepower, so to speak, to be successful here. After the key things about you, very important, but we've spent a lot of time talking about that over previous CaptainU live sessions. So I want to get to some of the other important stuff. Have 2 to 3 key questions for the coach. I think when you get into a conversation with a college and they say, you know, they ask the questions, they learn about you, they get a sense that maybe you're a good fit for their program, and they say, hey, what about you? Did you have any questions? If you just haven't put any thought into this, it's going to be, you know, it's not going to be quite as impressive it's not going to be as impressive as if you have something prepared, something that you clearly are actually curious about. You know, this is where I often have athletes or parents say, what's the best question to ask a college coach? The best question to ask is one that you're actually curious about. It's going to come through as a very authentic question rather than trying to have something prepared that's like a really good question. You know, if you are curious about the cost of your education at the school, ask about it. There's not some magical question that you should be worried about asking. What are you actually curious about? Maybe you're worried about being a D1 student athlete and still doing well in school. And you can ask, you know, what processes do you have in place to help the student athletes on your team excel in school? The school might say, hey, we've got A, B, and C, we've got X, Y, and Z, we've got tutors, we've got, people on the road that we can help you with, we've got systems of accountability in place. Ask about what's actually important to you. It is going to be much more engaging. The coach is going to be able to tell that you are mature, that you are not just trying to impress them by guessing what they want to hear. So don't be afraid to ask what you're actually curious about. And don't be afraid to ask about the cost of college. I find there's kind of two camps of people when it comes to asking about scholarships and financial aid. There's people who ask right out of the gate before they've even told the coach why they should be interested. They're like, hey, coach, can I have a scholarship? And, you know, that is perhaps not the most finessed way to go about recruiting. I recommend getting the coach interested first. But if you're having a dialogue, you're having a conversation with a coach, it is absolutely okay to bring it up. The other campus people who are just afraid to bring it up. The fact is, if a coach is having recruiting conversations with an athlete, the cost of education is going to come up at some point. And so don't be afraid to have that conversation. It's definitely okay to say, hey, coach, you're one of my top schools. I'm super interested in playing for your team. But one of the things that I must factor in making my college decision is the cost of an education. You know, what resources financially do you have available for the student athletes on your team? Asking that is 100% okay to do. Don't need to tiptoe around it. So I think that's an important note. That can be one of your key questions. So prepare 2 to 3 key questions of things you're actually curious about that help you evaluate if this school is going to be a good fit for you. Very, very, very important. Next. Definitely have prepared a reason or a few reasons why you are interested in going to their school. It's going to come up. The coach is going to say, hey, why'd you reach out? Or why are you interested in playing for our program? And if you have to make something up on the spot, it is going to be painfully obvious. Think about it beforehand. Is the major you're interested in studying, do they excel in that at the school? Is there something about the way that they train or they play? Do you have a personal connection? These are things that you should have thought of earlier in the recruiting process. But even if you have, write them down to help yourself remember. If you haven't, now is a good time to figure it out. Because when a coach asks you this question, why do you want to come to our program? And you got to like painfully make something up on the spot, it's going to be obvious. Know why you're interested in this school. And if you can't think of why you're interested in this school, you know, maybe it's not the best school for you. So this is an important exercise. Think about one story, some anecdote about something that you have had to overcome in your journey as a student athlete, some story of adversity, something you had to work through. Maybe you had an injury a couple years ago that really set you back and you came back stronger. Or maybe you had to earn a spot on a team that you thought was a given for you and you had to battle it out. Or maybe there was a key tournament or a game. You know, I think having some story of adversity and some story of you working through that, you know, every athlete has something that they can get across. But have a story in your back pocket in case it comes up. Something that you have written down the key details so that you don't have to be sitting there recalling it. You know, there's nothing, again, worse than a coach asking you a question, you going, well, can I think about it for a second? And then you've got, you know, 2 minutes of silence while you try and pick your brain for a good story. Have something prepared of a challenge that you have overcome as part of your, being a student athlete. It doesn't have to be something totally extraordinary. It doesn't have to be a once in a lifetime thing, but have that in mind beforehand. That's another thing you can prepare. And lastly, have something in mind that's something that you are working on as an athlete or as a student athlete. Something that does not come naturally to you, that is difficult, that is hard, that is indeed a weakness rather than a strength. And, you know, some coaches love to ask that question. You know, it's a pretty classic like job interview question. Hey, what's a weakness that you have? You know, I think a lot of people try and have like some tricky answer of like, oh, I care too much or something like that. You know, that's pretty obviously a strength that you're trying to repackage as a negative. Find something that you really truly need to work on and talk about how you're approaching working on that. I think that is going to come off as, you know, wow, this person can actually realize their weaknesses, they know their blind spots, and they're actively working to improve those or to mitigate those. I think that that is going to be much more impressive than trying to spin some positive as a negative. It's not always going to come up. It's not, you know, not every coach is going to ask that question. I think it's a little bit cliche, but sometimes it does come up. So have something like that prepared. Dave said, a good tip is for the players to follow up with a handwritten letter, not an email. Get the coach's address. Yeah, you know, I think that's a nice touch. You know, that's something that I definitely did when I was going through recruiting. You know, I think for some coaches, that's a very nice gesture. For some coaches, you know, they're just as happy with an email. You know, I think the world that we are in today is coaches aren't getting five letters from athletes that they respond to. You know, they're getting 500 emails sometimes at these programs. And so, you know, certainly not every program is you know, it's going to make all the world of difference. But everything that you are doing that is showing the coach that I am interested in your program, I am personalizing this for you, and I am taking the time to show you that is going to be a good thing. And so a handwritten letter, especially if this is a top program, I think is a great gesture. Although, you know, perhaps not 100% necessary in every situation, but I think it's a great tip, Dave. Thanks for sharing that. Now moving on. So we talked about preparation. You know, have your key points about yourself, have a couple key questions, have the reasoning why you're interested in this school, have a story about yourself, something that you've had to overcome, and know a blind spot or a weakness for yourself. Those are the key things you need to prepare. Now practice. This, I think most people understand that they need to prepare. Most people do not actually practice. And so what do I mean by practice? How do you practice for a phone call with a coach? There's a few things. First and foremost, practice by yourself. Look at your key points and just practice articulating those. Practice the different ways that you can say those to be clear and confident. You know, this is something that I myself do all the time. You know, I've had a couple coworkers say, wow, you know, the live sessions, we really enjoy watching them. They're super useful. You're so good at that. And it's like, well, I'm not good at this because I'm naturally good at it. I practice. I, you know, go on a walk, or I'll be sitting in the shower or just doing whatever, you know, whatever I'm doing, washing dishes, and just thinking about how I want to get my key points across. And, you know, hey, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I don't think that I'm the best person on the planet at giving these advice chats. But you know what? I know that I am better at these because I have these sort of mock conversations in my head. And I practice saying them sometimes out loud. And it can feel silly and awkward at first, but you are going to be more articulate and you are going to be more confident when you've done that. You know, I know a lot of the folks on our sales team that work with events and colleges and things like that, they do another thing that I recommend is mock calls. This is, you know, again, something the first time that I did a mock call, it was so awkward to me and so clunky and silly, and there was a lot of laughing. But the more that you practice, the more natural it will become. And so whether it's with a parent, with a coach, with me, if you're a gold or platinum subscriber and you want to have a mock call with a coach, I've done that with athletes, and just kind of have conversations and get what will happen is you will find the places that you stumble, and you will find the places that you do a great job of, and you'll be able to sort of, again, identify those blind spots. You'll be able to see, okay, what what things do I not have very much to say about, and I need to spend some more time thinking about evidence or anecdotes or stories, and what things did I ramble on way too much about? You know, having practice mock calls, I think, is a great way to prepare. Another thing you can do is you can practice on your safety schools. You know, I think a lot of folks who have this idea of exactly the school they want to go to, they're doing themselves a disservice when you only go after those schools, because you don't have the opportunity to actually practice these conversations. You will get better at writing messages to coaches the more that you do it. You will get better at having phone calls with coaches the more you do it. The first time you go on an official visit, it's going to be very nerve-wracking and you're not going to know what to expect. The second official visit is way easier. And so it's good to have a broad list, because it gives you more opportunity to practice these. Your dream school should not be your very first conversation. If it is, that's okay. You know, and for many athletes, it is that way. But hey, if you have the opportunity to practice a little bit on schools where you don't quite feel the same pressure, that's going to be a good thing. You really want to focus on speaking naturally and confidently. That is why practice matters. It is so obvious when somebody has prepared but not practiced. Because what happens is, the moment you start getting nervous on your call, you start rambling off all of your key points. You just start reading through your outline, and it just doesn't sound natural. It sounds like, oh, I'm nervous, I have all this stuff prepared, I'm gonna dump it all out to make sure that I get it all out. And the preparation is not about having everything that you are going to say on the call prepared. It is about having some sort of gas in the tank for when a certain situation comes up. If a coach says, you know, hey, talk to me about something that you've really had to struggle through and work through as a student athlete, you can immediately go, great, I've got this prepared, I've practiced telling the story, and I can do it confidently, and I can think about personalizing this to the coach rather than trying to scratch my head and make up something on the fly. So, practice it, and practice employing the bullet points that you've prepared rather than just regurgitating everything immediately. I think that that is where you can really get to a next level, super useful, super engaging phone call rather than just being a ball of stress when you're on the line. You know, some people are going to be natural at this, and that's okay. I think most people are not, and that's definitely okay. This is a skill set that takes, you know, sometimes a lifetime to develop. I am certainly getting better at speaking and having phone calls, and I've been doing these for 7 years at CaptainU. So don't expect to be great right away. It takes practice, and it takes preparation, and it takes being intentional. And that kind of leads me to talking about the last thing, is the pressure of these. We talked about preparation, we talked about practice. I want to talk about pressure, because athletes, and, you know, truly I do find this is more athletes often putting pressure on themselves. Most of the time it's parents trying to mitigate that pressure. But certainly I have seen parents that really put a lot of pressure on this, and I don't think that necessarily helps. You know, it's important to know that it's okay to be nervous for a phone call with a college coach. It's just okay to be nervous. Coaches know you're going to be nervous. It's 100% okay. And sometimes, practicing and preparing will mitigate that pressure. But sometimes you're still going to feel it. And, if you're on the call and you want to say, you stumble for a moment, the call isn't over. You're not out of the running, this coach, because you stumbled for a moment. And in fact, it's okay to say, hey, I'm sorry, I'm having a little bit of trouble articulating myself. I'm really nervous because I'm really, really excited about your school. It's okay to even just call it out. Being nervous and feeling the pressure is okay. And it's also important to note that a single phone call, a single interaction, a single message is not make or break with the recruiting process. Like I said earlier in this, and like I've said time and time again, coaches recruit people, and you need to build rapport with coaches. And so if you have a single bad phone call, it's okay to follow it up. Hey coach, thanks so much for the conversation today. I had a couple things that I didn't quite get across that I wanted to elaborate on. You know, I sort of was pulled into our moment on the conversation, and here's a little extra information I wanted to send your way for your consideration. I think that it's just okay to call it out, and it's not a make or break situation. I think that's very, very important.